thinking whether the vaccinated people can actually transmit the virus to others. We have to understand that no vaccine is 100% effective. So there will be people who will be infected despite being vaccinated. It's a small proportion, of course. Vaccines are very effective, but there will be few individuals who actually do get sick. And these people, they can actually transmit as well to others. So that said, we also have to consider that the vaccines were designed primarily to protect us severe disease. That means that the endpoints in clinical trials were actually disease and not infection. However, we also know that people who have mild infections or are asymptomatic, they do not transmit the virus as efficiently to others as people who have more severe disease. So that means that to some extent, even if you can get infected, then anyway, the ability to transmit will be lower. There are first data that indicate that a vaccine may also protect us from infection. So that means we will not get infected, so we will have no virus to transmit to others. But we're still waiting for more data to accumulate on this topic. I have myself already vaccinated, and I must say I was waiting for that moment very much. I think that's because it takes away a lot of tension and stress about getting sick myself, about infecting my parents or other relatives who might be more vulnerable for the disease. But also, I think one big motivation for me was to somehow contribute to combating the epidemic. And this is quite important for our lives to normalize. Unless we all get vaccinated, the pandemic will continue. Of course, there's not such a thing as we all get vaccinated. There will be always people who cannot get the vaccine for different medical reasons. But we need to get vaccinated as many of us as possible and as quickly as possible to be able to stop the epidemic, to be able to stop the virus to replicate, to multiply, to have a chance to mutate and produce new variants that might be of concern, that the vaccine will be less effective. So all of this these factors, and also to get our health systems back to operating normally and not have to constantly shift resources towards COVID. So all of these factors are quite important. And yes, we have to vaccinate, all of us. they are different in many ways. The methodology, the technology of construction of the vaccine is different. So we have the vaccine basing of mRNA technology, this new method of development of vaccines. We have vector vaccines, which means that part of genetic material of the coronavirus is inserted in another virus, the vector virus. But we also have subunit vaccines. That means that the protein of the virus is used as a material in the vaccine. So this different technological aspects also mean that there are different storage conditions required for different vaccines. That means that there might be different dosing, one dose or two doses, and perhaps the interval between the two doses may be different. There is also reported differences in efficacy in clinical trials of the vaccines. But we have to underline that all vaccines protect against severe disease.